Okay, and we're back. Shouldn't have any sort of audio delay on anything now. Okay, so yeah, let me just get a little, here's my shill background. Let me just get a little something in the background while we're on intermission here. Something familiar, something calming and soothing, of course. Let me just poke through some things here. Yeah, I think this'll do. Oh man, this might just be real loud, too. Well, okay, here we go. Oh yeah, that volume. But okay, turning it down now. There you go. That should be about right. All right, so there's your background music. That's your intermission music. I'll be back here in about, maybe 10 minutes tops, I'd say. 9:50 at the latest. Just a little break, So go to the bathroom, get your snacks, get your sweet, sweet Mountain Dew and Doritos and Doritos, and we'll be back in about 10 minutes. Alright. Just getting back here in the seat. Still got a few minutes, but yeah, I'm just gonna set some things up now. I'm gonna take a look at what my options are. Let's see what I wanna, you know, what I wanna stream. And yeah, I got some. I got everything. Yeah, just kind of got the kitchen all nice and ready for. Yeah, gonna make some very nice grilled chicken and rice. And, dice a little bit of bacon and veggies up in there, too. Come out real good. But, yeah, I just got all that ready for later. So, let's see. What do I want to play? That's the question. Man, you know, I wish I could, I want to stream some more SimCity Society's, destinations. Like, I really, really do want to do more of that, you know, just for fun. But, like, the game crashes constantly now. And I'm not sure if it's, like, I'm not sure exactly what's causing the, what's causing the crash. But, yeah. And I'm sure you take a little intermission break and that pretty much clears out the stream. You know, everybody, you know, fucks off, goes to bed, and all that good stuff. Let's see, what could I do? What could I do? You know, I could continue King's Quest VIII, Mask of Eternity. I mean, it's usually kind of my midnight stream thing. I don't usually do it like, I see. Yeah, I'm just kind of thinking what I want to do here. Right now we're kind of, I guess it's kind of infringing on the whole midnight stream slot, you know, where I just play random stuff, but it's still kind of early for that, too. I could do a little King's Quest VIII Mask of Eternity. I'd already started it up. I'm at the Dimension of Death right now, which is, you know, fun times. But, I don't know. See, what else have I got? I had a few more emulator games ready, just getting them ready to go. I got the, the infamous Bubsy in Claws Encounters of the Furred Kind. Oh, God. And there's also a game, it's a kind of an RPG, it's an adventure game more so, I'd say, Twisted Tales of Spike McFang. It's a, I don't know, it's a very odd game, but it's one of those things I remembered it from when I was a kid, but, like, I never knew what the game was called. I only, discovered what it was called a few years ago, when I finally got to play it. I got Plock, which I don't think I'm ready for, I'm not ready for round two of Plock. I gotta get good for that. I mean, I could always do a little bit of, a little bit of the old Zombies Ate My Neighbors. It's kind of fun just to see how far you can get each time you do it. It's fun just to see how far you can get when you try to play that game. I got Lagoon. Yeah, it's about time to start up. So let me think what I really want to do here. Well, I guess, you know, since you're here, you know, I can't decide. Like, I can't decide what I want to play. So, what do you think? You know, should I continue with that, action RPG, you know, King's Quest Mask of Eternity? You know, gotta adventure in that dimension of death. Or should I bust out the emulators, do some, you know, a good game, like Zombies Ate My Neighbors? Or should I do a, not-so-good game? Like Bubsy, or, or, I mean, I have some other things, too, that I could try to get working, but, like, they're not really prepared, so that might be a little, you know, might be a rough start to things. I don't know, decisions, right? Either way, let me just unplug the old capture card here. Yeah, it's a nice and healthy Windows bloop. Let me get my but see, I can't decide. See, let me get my controller. Yeah, I gotta get my controller all unwound and plugged in. Make sure it's still working. Turns red, so I'm gonna guess it's good. Alright, well, you know, I think, I don't know, what have I been playing? I've been playing fairly decent games. I mean, like Siren Blood Curse, that was kind of questionable, right? That was a questionable decision, but everything else is relatively good. I mean, even Dino Crisis, for all its problems, it's a good game. So, yeah, I think I'll do something very not good. Yeah, I think I'll just put away those good games and, let me just, crack into the other old emulator I got here. Yeah, I need to play something to offset all that good. Like, we've had way too much good going on here. Like, way, way too much good. So yeah, let's do some Quattro Adventure, you know? I've done that before. Like, I think I've done Quattro Adventure like 3 or 4 times on my stream. But I always go back to it because, okay, my goal in life, like, okay, I'm gonna spoil it. My goal in life, like, if it's anything, it's to beat at least one game on Quattro Adventure. Just one, you know? I mean, hey, if I can beat all of them, that's like, you know, I think I could just, you know, I could commit seppuku right there, but I just want to beat one of them. Just one. So let me, let me make sure everything is configured right. It looks like it. Alright, let's turn off that soothing mood music. And, and just get everything booted up and, you know, ready to go. Looks good. Looks great. Looks grand. Let's, let's just switch over to this, and here we go. Alright. So, this is Quattro Adventure. Delightful little thing. I don't know if I can get rid of that little bit at the bottom of the screen. I don't think I can. Let me see if I can. That doesn't really solve the problem. So, yeah, there's gonna be a little white bar there at the bottom, but that's just part of the thing. So, I could go into the whole, you know, thing explaining what this is, but long story short, this is a game that, you know, see, as a kid, I didn't have no Mario, I didn't have no, Mega Man or anything. I mean, I had them later on, like, much later on I had them, but like to start, no, I had this. And what this is it's a special gold cartridge, one of those shiny gold ones. You couldn't buy it in stores. You can only buy it off the home shopping network. And it was basically one of those things where, parents would look at it and say, "Hey, four games in one, that's a bargain. That's a deal." I mean, most of these things, they're just one game. This is four games. What could go wrong? What could possibly go wrong? But let's do it. So, Linus Spacehead. So, each one of these games has a critical problem, a fatal flaw, if you will. See if you can spot them. Right, level one, Bubble Trouble. And I'm gonna try to beat these. Like, I'm actually gonna try to beat these, but yeah, so level one, I'm drowning. I need to get out of the water because I am drowning right now. So I gotta make some good time to get out of here. So okay, here's what I'm gonna say. I'm gonna play each one of these games, but when I run out of continues or otherwise game over, I'm just done. Like, I'm not gonna. Yeah, like, if I game over, it's done. That's the rule. I move on to the next game on the cartridge. Although with one exception, there is one exception to that little self-imposed rule. But I'll get to that when I get to it. So yeah, now I'm really trying to get the fuck out of here before I run out of oxygen. Level one, easy enough. Level two, Life's a Beach. Now, I learned about a secret on this stage, and I want to try to use that to my advantage as much as I can. All right, now controls are a little slippery. I'll say that right now. Controls are very slippery for Linus Spacehead. He's always kind of doing the slip and slide, and sometimes that makes him miss jumps. So yeah, secret. Now, look at that. Just a whole little secret in there, just filled up with life-giving power-ups. Well, not power-ups, because power-up would imply that it somehow makes Linus not quite as shit, but okay, what it does, yeah, it gives you some lives. Extra lives. Alright. Now, you want to jump over the crab, but you can't, alright? Just saying it right now, can't make that jump. So, okay, I gotta do this real careful, like, alright, there we go. Now, see, if that bird had caught me, it would have taken me all the way back to the beginning of the level. Like, no mercy. Oh, hey, look! I didn't quite make the jump, it was a little too tight. But yeah, see, if the birds, if they catch you, they don't kill you, unlike everything else in the game. When the bird catches you, it just takes you back to the beginning of the level. So, have fun with that, Alright, so we gotta be careful here, we gotta go slow. Because if there's anything that, the children loved with their NES games, it was going slow. Okay, didn't quite make it again. Yeah, I am trying here, but. Like, if I could explain the problem with Linus's controls. Okay, see, there's a little bit of a delay when you hit the button to jump and when he actually jumps. And no, this isn't like an emulator problem. It's a problem with the game. I can tell you because I do own the actual cartridge. Yeah, it's a problem with that too. And the thing is, the game wants you to make a lot of very specific jumps. The jumps have to be really precise, but if you wait just a nanosecond too long, like if you wait just a second too long, you'll miss the jump. You'll just completely miss it. Alright, so I'm just gonna let that coconut fall. good. And then that happens, and then those controls, they're not responsive. They're really not. Like, I tried to jump there, but Linus just didn't do anything. You know, he just slid right off the ground and into the ocean. Like, I'm not, I really don't do the whole, you know, I don't play anything up. There's no acting involved in this channel here. Like, when I, you know, make a fall like that, you know, something happens, it's because the game just doesn't control it. It's not because I'm, doing it on purpose, just in case you were wondering. Because if I could, I really want to beat this. Like, I want to get to the end. I want to see that, you know, congratulations at the end. Okay, so we're gonna let the coconut fall. We're gonna jump, and we're gonna jump back. And hey, look, we did good that time. Alright, that I'm gonna have to jump over. Okay, good. Okay. Alright, awesome. And hey, look, I got the first piece of Linus's radio. Yeah, that's actually the goal of the game, is to get all the radio pieces. Oh yeah, those fucking crabs, no. Oh god, no. Alright, so we're gonna jump. And there's a bird, and I want to, I don't want to get caught by the bird. Because again, you get caught by the- Oh shit, I got caught by the bird. I got caught by the bird. So guess what I get to do all over again. Yeah. Yeah, oh, guess what? Those coconuts respawn. So I have to do this trick jump again. I have to do the trick jump again. Oh. And again, you know, no acting. Oh god, this game. Alright, so, alright, we're gonna let the coconut go over us. So yeah, we clearly picked the wrong thing to do there. Alright, clearly the right thing to do. I don't even know what the right thing to do here is. I mean, like, look, the bird, it's just gonna, like, it just respawns, right? Like, the bird just respawns, doesn't it? Like, I'm pretty sure the bird just respawns when you, like, you know, when you get too close. Okay, I'm not seeing the bird, so, okay. Yeah, so the bird did not respond, so let's do it. Let's do this thing. Oh, hey, look, there's the bird. I guess he does respawn. He does come back for more. No. Okay. Alright, so, I don't know, can I... Like, maybe I have to go faster? Like, maybe that's the answer, is that I gotta go fast? Alright. I think I just made it. Yeah, I made it through level 2. Awesome. Yeah, so level 3, Clifftop Capers. Oh goddamn, Linus! No, Linus, stop jumping! Yeah, see, then he couldn't stop jumping. Controls, right? Also, here's the other problem with all the games on this cartridge. Yeah, you have to start over from the very beginning every time. Every single time, you have to restart from the beginning. So, you know, I'm gonna stay true to my word here. I'm resetting the cartridge, and let's try, you know, I'm gonna save Super... I always save Super Robin Hood for last, because Super Robin Hood, it's actually the most fun game on the whole cart. So, let's try Boomerang Kid. And again, I'm going till I lose. Alright, when I lose the game, it's over. You know, that's when we, yeah, that's when we move on to the next one. So, okay, Boomerang Kid. It's got the same problems as all the other games. The controls don't quite work right. You know, it's both slippery and way too precise at the same time, which I don't know how that happens, but it does. And of course, you know, you get hit, you die, it's game over, all the way back to the beginning. That's another problem with it. Also, the other problem with it... Oh, hey there, yeah, Linus Spacehead, I don't know about Easy. Yeah, Linus Spacehead has problems. Like, I'm sure there's a better version of Linus Spacehead, but the one on this cartridge, nah. Nah. Okay, so, here's what I'm gonna do, yeah, there's one other problem with Boomerang Kid, and that's fall damage. Like, okay, like, this jump right here. Well, I might do that one eventually, but see, I play this one because I, you know, I had it as a kid. I liked it as a kid. I liked it. So yeah, problem, if I fell off right here, like if I just ran right straight forward, you know, and I landed on the ground, I would die. Yeah, that jump would kill me. There's fall damage in this game. You know, so that's another problem. Yeah, the fall damage. Also, there's a time limit, you'll notice, at the bottom of the screen. Yeah, if you take a little too long, you know, figuring out these puzzles, or, you know, or an enemy just doesn't want to move, yeah, you'll find that, you run out of time. Well, of course, you know, Bubsy has fall damage. You know, but you expect that out of Bubsy. But, you know, a game, you know, the fucking Boomerang Kid, right? Like, the fucking Boomerang Kid, you know, if Kangaroo's all, like, I mean, why can't he take some fall damage, you know? Like, you don't expect fall damage on the NES. I mean, what fucking NES game has fall damage, you know? Alright, but I'm actually playing for keeps here. Like, I'm trying to win. So, yeah, I'm gonna try my hardest to actually get as far as I can possibly get in this game. So, you know, maximum concentration here. Maximum concentration. And also, I hope that music gets burned into your brain too, because it just doesn't let up, it doesn't stop. All right, good job there. Oh, hey, look, we made it. We're out of the outback. So, you know, what's the natural progression for a game called, you know, Boomerang Kid, right? You know, he starts in the outback. You know, he starts in the outback. So where does the Boomerang Kid go next? Like, what could he possibly do after you've cleared the outback levels? Well, of course, the next obvious progression is, you know, he goes to Castlevania, and he has to deal with the gargoyles and you know, Medusa heads and shit like that. No, see, he doesn't. No rescuing the princess. We need to kill Dracula right now. I think that's, of course, the only thing that the Boomerang Kid could possibly do. Like, where could he go from here? You know, the Boomerang Kid is a long lost Belmont. You know, he needs to, yeah, gotta get that Dracula. Okay, so I want to just go back the other way, but, yeah, we kind of need to get, I'm gonna fucking run out of time. I spent too long strategizing. Yeah, see, no time to strategize, okay? No time. You gotta move. You gotta fucking move. I want to go, but it's like, oh, no, I'll let him, you know, let him go do his thing. Alright, I'm just gonna go for it. Alright, so I need to get up there. Okay, wait, what? 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 Okay, I couldn't get there. Alright, let's try this again. Okay, I'm gonna... Wait, can I get there? Okay, I can. So yeah, you can't make mistakes in Boomerang Kid. There are no mistakes allowed. If you make a mistake, it's pretty much game over. Yeah, so no mistakes, 100% run. And we're gonna be very close on time here, too. Yeah, look at that, look at that. You know, no time. Yeah, you know, the Boomerang Kid, he needs to have that barbecue, you know? Have some barbecue, some Fosters, and make love to his kangaroo. I don't really know. So, oh god, there's a switch. And there's, what is all this? What is all this now? Like, see, you have to take a moment to just take the levels in, to really comprehend what you're even looking at. But that, you know, you can't do that, right? Because, you know, see, yeah, like, you can't do that. You can't take time to look at the levels. See, oh, look at this. Look at this shit. So when I hit the pause button, yeah, it makes the level go black. So you can't, you know, you can't, like, you can't take your time, right? You can't take any amount of time to, yeah, you cannot take any amount of time to just look at the level, like, examine it, you know, see what the fuck is going on. Oh, hey, that kills me, too. So yeah, yeah, so hey look, I got a high score though. I got a high score. Awesome. Alright, I got on the leaderboard, guys. So yeah, you have to do the whole game over again, you know? Oh yeah, I mean, like, the problem with the problem with Linus Spacehead, the problem is really that, fucking Linus Spacehead, like, it's just, there's so much bullshit in it. It's the pixel-perfect jumps that you have to make, combined with the slippery, bad controls. You know, that's the... You know, like I said, it's my mission in life to beat these games. I've been trying since I was a kid to beat these games, but yeah, and to beat them, you know, fairly. Like, no save states, no cheating. I want to beat these games legit. If I can do that, I think I've won at life. But yeah, I'm just trying each one, you know, just each one. Yes, Dizzy. Let's try a little bit of Dizzy. Now, I said that, you know, my self-imposed thing here is that, my self-imposed thing is that, I go till I die. But yeah, look how easy it is to die in Bubsy. You know, like, look how easy, or not Bubsy. Oh god, it's all mixing together. Look how easy it is to die in Dizzy, you know? He might as well be Bubsy with how easy he dies, but... Oh, hey there. Yeah, hey there, cats. Yeah, thing about Dizzy. So yeah, like, this is the one where I break my little rule about, you know, die once and it's a new game. Yeah, those torches in the background, they'll kill you if you, run into them. Yeah, this purple thing makes your controls go reverse. Yeah, you know, I got reverse controls now. So, Dizzy's moonwalking, going, you know, left is right, right is left, all good stuff. Hey, look, there's a trap. I'm not gonna fall for that. You know, who do you think I am? So yeah, I'm not gonna fall for that. But hey, look! There's some- oh, hey, look! There's a trap. Yeah, that trap just came off the screen. Just came out of fucking nowhere. And then, yeah, you start over from the beginning. But, like I said, I'm actually gonna try. So, alright, so, if I die one more time, then it's, you know, start over from the beginning. But, or, you know, it's start a different game up. But, yeah, I'm gonna try now. So we're gonna do this. Let's do it. You know, let's try to beat this game, you know? Like, I think I can do it. I think I can beat the game. Let's not get the purple guy this time. Although, there is a coin down here. Yeah, I've heard that Dizzy is not a very fun franchise. Yeah, like, my understanding is that Dizzy is all about the cheap deaths, which, yeah, that kind of makes me want to play the, you know, I kind of want to play a Dizzy game. Like, I want to play a proper one. You know, like a proper, a full Dizzy game. But for now, you know, the one on Quattro Adventure is the only one I've ever played. But I'm just gonna see how far I can get. And hey, you know, I think it kind of makes sense too, doesn't it? Like Dizzy is an egg, right? Like he's a walking egg. Yeah, he's like a walking egg, so of course, you know, of course he breaks. You know, he just, you know, he breaks, and it's just, oh man, scrambled eggs everywhere. So okay, what do I want to do here? I'm trying to think. Do I want to go under there? Like, is there any purpose to that? I don't think there is. Yeah, I don't think there's really any purpose to that. But I think you kind of have to do this. Yeah, like, you kind of have to go under the traps. Like, you have to get close to them. Like, you have to get dangerously close to the traps. Oh, man, I love, you know, I love to go back and do some old NES games. Although, like, I gotta admit, I prefer Super Nintendo games if I'm, I prefer Super Nintendo or DOS if I'm going to relive old memories, but there's certainly some, you know, there's certainly some fun NES games. I mean, like Crystalis, that's one I want to play eventually, but I want to finish up one of the other games that I'm doing. Like I want to finish up Dino Crisis. I'll probably finish up Dino Crisis and then, like, I'll start up Crystalis, maybe. Or maybe I'll just do it as a one-off, you know? I'm not really sure just yet. So wait, I need to get up there. There was no way to proceed, right? There was like a wall, right? There was totally not a wall. Okay, let's do it. Oh, look! Dizzy can't squeeze through there. That would be absurd. Why, that would just be ridiculous. Yeah, you know, I still find some, you know, I still find a few games that I hadn't played that I want to play. So let's see, we got a magic pebble, a rubber snorkel, and a heavy weight. Well, you know what we're gonna have to do with that snorkel? Oh, hey, look, see, I'm gonna... No way to know that that's there, like, there's no way to know. Okay, let's put that heavy weight right there. So yeah, the heavy weight kind of lets you get over here, right? Also, let's see if I can get over here. Can we jump that? Yes, I can. All right. Let's go up here. Yeah, that's yeah, that's quite a gap there. Oh, hey, look, there was another trap. Cause hey, you know, I didn't get enough traps out of this game. So okay, let's I think that's something I need over there. Alright, so yeah, I'm gonna take the magic, or not the magic pebble, but the infrared detonator. I don't think I'm not even sure what any of the items in this game do. I don't remember. All I know is that I need to keep moving. You know, keep fucking moving forward. So, okay, I'm gonna put this item, like, down here. So here's our items. I'm gonna leave the detonator down there. I'm gonna take the pebble and, the snorkel. Yeah, you can only have three items at a time. So, you know, have fun with that. So, alright, I'm gonna get the shovel here. Now, okay, do you think it's gonna be safe to jump down? I don't know, but I don't wanna... Let's see what happens. Let's see what fucking happens. Oh shit, there's items up here. Look at that shit, there's items up here. There are fucking items to be had up here. Well, what do I take with me? I mean, okay, like I got a snorkel, a magic pebble, a gravedigger's thing, I mean... The fuck do I want to take with me? Well, I know I want the pogo stick, right? I think that's for something coming up relatively soon. Yeah, I think the shovel is also for a puzzle that's here. I don't know. Yeah, you know, yeah, Dizzy was just, it was just too good. It was too good, it had to be released. With some next-gen, you know, graphics and all that. Or if not, it's just, you know, just you had to pack all that content in there. It's okay. Am I gonna die? Leap of faith. Leap of faith. Okay, that's enough of that. I think I might just die if I keep laughing. Okay. So that's Dizzy. That's all for Dizzy this time around. I can't. All right. So let's try the last game, and this game is actually kind of fun. So yeah, let's try this last game. Yeah, you know, some games were meant to stay buried, you know? Some games were meant to, you know, to stay, hidden away in their, you know, in their sacred tombs. Alright, so yeah, this game, I actually like this one. Like, this one's actually kind of fun. Now, when I say it's kind of fun, you know, I don't mean it's good. Don't mistake me there. I don't mean good, I mean it's kind of fun. So yeah, it has that sluggish, it's got all the sluggish controls that you want out of a Quattro Adventure title. You know, all the sluggish controls and bullshit you could want. Alright, so let's see. Okay, kill that. I need a key or something from here. Can't shoot him. He's too short. I do like this, that they give you a nice, So yeah, like, I'll spoil this right now. They give you a bow and arrow, right? There's only, like, one enemy in the whole game you can actually kill with it, and that's the regular crossbow guys. Like, they're the only enemy in the game that can be killed with the bow and arrow. All the other enemies, they don't take damage from it. Or you just, you know, you otherwise can't hit them. Oh yeah, Robin Hood, he's just, you know, he's loving it. He's loving the dungeon. Yeah, so the name of this game, you know, it's all about treasure, alright? It's all about collecting treasure, getting keys, unlocking doors, and otherwise, you know, just getting to the end of the game. So, this game, it's one of the less, like, I would say it's probably the least bullshit out of all the games on this whole cartridge. So I actually like this one. Like, like when I was a kid, I'd just play this one for fun, right? And again, you can't kill that spider. That would be silly, all right? And what do you think? Do you think Robin Hood has a weapon or something? I mean, come on. Oh, great. But hey, look, yeah, this game is actually kind of lenient because it gives you a health bar. Yeah, like if you look at the left side of the screen, I have 4 hearts. That means I can get hit 4 times before I lose a life. And then, hey, on top of the health bar, I have lives. You know, I got 2 lives over there to the side. So yeah, there's some. There's less bullshit going on here than all the other ones, because, you know, in all the other ones, it's like, you know, you die 1 to 3 times and then game over, right? But no, like this one, you can make it, you know, you have a chance, all right? Now, I mean, of course, like, there are some things that, like, if you run into them, you'll die. Like if I fall into the lava, you know, you lose a life. Also, you might notice that there's a drill coming out of the ceiling. Yeah, there's lots of those. There's lots of drills that they just kind of come out of the ceiling. They come out of the floor. Sometimes they come out of the wall. Like, you know, they always pop out at the best time too. But you know, that's just, you know, a little. I mean, come on, it wouldn't be a Quattro adventure game if there wasn't a little bit of bullshit, right? It wouldn't feel authentic to the label. So, yeah, let's get that treasure. 'Cause hey, Robin Hood needs his treasure, right? He's all about the treasure. He is all about that. You know, he's all about, you know, get the riches, get the bitches. I'm sure that's exactly how Robin Hood went. That's how I remember Robin Hood. Oh, look, yeah, not quite enough time to slide under that crossbow bolt right there. But hey, look, convenient, you know, they spawn me right in there, so like you know, they allow me to just get right back into it. You know, I mean, of course, they do spawn me right in front of the crossbow, but hey, you know, that's just a little goof, you know, just a little goof amongst friends here. So, okay, let's try to time this out, right? Alright. Oh. Okay, so this guy fires like 4 times, I think. Yeah, 4 times. And the combat looks very exciting, doesn't it? Okay. So now, there's nowhere to go, right? Like, I mean, I can't, you know, that key didn't do anything. Well, guess what? Yeah, if you jump over there, ladder comes down. No, it doesn't make any sense. Don't worry about it, all right? Don't worry about it. Also, you gotta have momentum to get through that. Oh, hey, look, there's another drill. Great. All right. But we're doing good here. See, look at that. Just, you know, get in, get out. Okay, and just wait for that to come down. And now here's what I do. I just sit here. All right, awesome. Hey, I love the graphics in this. They're very well. Hey, like I can kind of tell what mostly everything is, right? So hey, that's fine. You know, like as long as you can kind of tell what it is, it's all good. All right, so. Yeah, we just got a key. Trying to remember where, you know, where does that key go, right? Oh, hey, look. The nice hitbox. Okay, so let's just hop over here. Hop over here. Oh. It's a little bit slippery. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay. So we need to get another key. And there's another key, like, right here. Oop. I thought they could get me with that. Now, okay, I would like to know how the hell I'm supposed to get, like... Oh, wait, actually, I think I kind of know. Oh, yeah, look at that. You use the barrel, right? Okay, so here's the trick here. There's a trick, alright? There's a trick. I'm telling you there's a trick. So, okay, you do that, then... Oh, and you jump on the barrel. See? Yeah. They kind of expect you just to know how to do that. Now, I have to hit this guy over here. He fires twice. Yeah, you have to do a running shot, because, you know, he builds up that momentum. Yeah, see, he builds up some momentum. Nothing over here. Nothing over there. Alright, so there's a bat. Okay, I just wanted to get that bat killed, because, you know, he's gonna be a problem. Alright, so we just want to go over here. Well. You know, I got hit, but it's okay. Like, this game is actually, it's actually really generous with the health, you know? Yeah, like, I have no idea where those barrels are even coming from, but, yeah, but hey, we're into a whole new area. Oh, look, it just bounced me right up into that. That's nice. That's nice. Okay, so let's, make our way down here. Yeah, that's a nice big old drill right there. Just, you know, that pops out and goes straight up Robin Hood's ass. Just all the way in, you know? Just gets right up in there. Okay, so, yeah, we need to make a little, I think I can kill this guy. Yeah, see? That gets rid of him, right? Okay, that, yeah, let's just get there. Now, I know there was treasure there. I know there was treasure. But, you know, fuck you, I'm not that suicidal, alright? I'm not gonna go for it. Alright, so now, I need to make a fun little... Okay. Gotta make a fun little jump to a disappearing platform. Oh, wait, what? I look away for like 2 seconds. I looked away for like 2 seconds. Okay. It started me in a good place, though. That's nice. Okay, I wanna get up there. I wanna jump. Alright, like, maybe I think... Yeah, I must have accidentally gone to the lava. That's okay. It's okay. I'm doing actually really good. Okay, I didn't really have a way to dodge that. That's fine. That's fine. Okay, yeah. I'm still doing good. Yeah, I do like the music. Like, this music... Oh, hey, look! A drill. I got drilled again. Oh! Nice! You know, like, because of Robin Hood's slip-and-slide action, you know, I tried to dodge out of the way of the fireball, and I slipped right into the drill. There's really a... Oh, great! The platform was just a bit off, so... Yeah. So, game over! That's, yeah, that's Quattro Adventure. Did I get on the high score? Hey, I got the high score! Great, great. Great, great. Great. So, you know, okay, here's another great thing. Like, you know, okay, so they have these high scores, right? You know, they got these high scores, but... Here's the thing. The high scores, they reset. They reset every single time you turn off the cartridge. So, yeah. But anyway, but hey, like, every time I play these games, like, every single time I play Quattro Adventure, I get just a little bit better at it. You know, I get a little bit better, I get a little bit further, and hey, one of these days, I might even beat it. One of these days. But okay, let's, I think that's enough of that. Let me switch to something else. You know, I think it's about time. I think it's about time that I, yeah, I definitely think it's time that, I busted out a real classic game, you know, like a game, a true classic. Yeah, I think it's time for a true classical video game. Yeah, it's that time. So, yeah, it's that time. It's that time. Oh, yeah. It's everyone's favorite Bobcat. I mean, look, it's Bubsy. Like, he's catchy, he's hip, he's cool. You know, he's better than Mario and that Sonic guy. He's better than all them combined. You know, like, Bubsy is a true action hero, okay? And he will just worm his way into your heart. So, here we go. Yeah, the game was playing itself there. But here we go. So, yeah. Aw, man, Bubsy! So let me just remember how this works. So yeah, you have a jump, and you have a glide. As long as you're gliding, I don't believe you can take fall damage, so... You know, hey, that's the thing. Like, yes, Bubsy does have, like, if Bubsy falls, you know, he dies. But if he's gliding, he won't die. So, you know, there's that, right? See, like, if I didn't glide, I'd just die. But if you glide, even just a little bit, you're okay. So yeah, I want to go fast. Like, again, you know, anyone who's familiar with Bubsy, and I'm pretty sure everyone is familiar, everyone knows Bubsy, right? Like, Bubsy is a household name at this point, right? So yeah, look, you want to go fast, right? But you go fast, and bad things happen, you know? You go fast, and you slip on the bananas, and you fall into the sewer, and you die, you know? Yeah, so you want to go fast, but listen, kid, you don't want to go fast. I mean, I know you think you want to go fast, okay? You think you want to go fast, but you don't want to go fast, alright? So, yeah, like, even though this is a game that very much so, it feels like it should be, like, a fast-paced game, but it's just so goddamn zoomed in that you can't see where you're going. Like, you just can't fucking see where you're going. And, like, if I fall there, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna die. So, yeah, I'm gonna go slow here. I'm gonna go real fucking slow. But maybe I'll go fast. No, see, look, you don't want to go fast, because I would have run right into that. Oh no, he's flipping upside down, it's all kinds of kooky. Bubsy's got everything, you know, he's got that Mode 7. I mean, you know, fucking Mode 7, you know, Bubsy, he's got that Mode 7. He's, you know, get the fuck out of here with your blast processing, alright? You know, we don't talk about blast processing here, alright? Okay, so I think there might be a bonus stage over here somewhere. And there might be. Oh yeah, it's a bonus stage. Kids love bonus stages. You know, kids fucking love it. Especially bonus stages that just kind of shoot you back and forth and waste your time. Those are the best kinds, aren't they? No, I've never, you know, I will be honest here, I've only watched one person play Bubsy, and they didn't play it very well, so yeah. But you know, hey look, I might talk a lot of shit about Bubsy, right? I think everyone talks shit about Bubsy, right? But look, here's the thing, you know, Bubsy, oh look, he died, I went too fast, excuse me, yeah, excuse me, I went too fast, I'm sorry. But yeah, you know, no, I talk a lot of shit about Bubsy, but hey, look, it's actually kind of fun. Like, it actually is. Like, Bubsy is actually kind of fun to play. I mean, again, nothing about Bubsy feels good, right? Like, it doesn't feel like a good game. It's not a good game. But, as not good of a game as it is, you know, I have fun with it. Like, I have some kind of strange, perverted pleasure out of playing Bubsy, and I'm not sure why. But I get something out of it. Oh no, the screen's going all crazy. I gotta slow down, man. I gotta go slow. But yeah, I've actually, like, I've beaten Bubsy so many times. It's not an easy task, I'll say that right now. Like, it's not an easy thing to beat Bubsy, but it, you know, I... Oh, look at that! Look at that shit! Look at that shit! Look at that shit! I just fell through the thing, like... You know, I don't know. Like, I don't know about that, you know, Mario, Mario 64, I will admit it's been a long time since I played it, but like, Mario 64 had relatively good controls. I think the only problem with, kind of any N64 game is that, like, one stick, you know, like, it's only got one stick, the controller. Like, I don't really know what they were thinking, you know, like, I don't really know what they were thinking with the N64's controller, right? But, yeah, like, I don't know, I think, you know, Mario 64 still handles alright, like, I don't think it's got problems with that. Like, if anything, camera angles, like, it has some camera angle issues, I think, but that's, like, all I really remember. Oh, hey, I think I gotta continue there, that's good. You know, I think, like, you're supposed to run through those yarn balls, right? Like, you're supposed to run through them, and yarn shoots out, and that's all fun times, right? But yeah, you have to be going fast, and I don't want to go fast, this is Bubsy. You know, it's like, what are you trying to do to me, Bubsy? You're trying to make me go fast. You know what happens when you go fast, right? You can't handle that. Yeah, wee, look at that, it's fun, right? It's fun to do the, you know, the slip and slide, you know, down a weird floating log with water coming out of it. It's fun, right? Yeah, also, the yarn... I don't know, like, the yarn in this game, like, I think maybe in the second game the yarn did something, but... In the first game, like, all the yarn is basically, it's just points, right? Like, it's, like, all it does is give you points, and as far as I know, like, you don't get an extra life or anything for getting points, right? Like, you don't get an extra continue or anything for getting points, right? I'm pretty sure you don't. So, all the yarn... Yeah, that's kind of the thing. Like, you know, Bubsy is he's a bobcat. That's, you know, a bobcat is not the same thing as a cat. I don't know why they picked yarn as his thing. It's kind of weird. Like, it's kind of weird, really, that they decided to go with that. I mean, I guess they figured, you know, like, okay, look, you know, Mario, Mario has coins, right? You know, Mario has coins. Sonic, oh hey look, I jumped on an enemy and it killed me. But yeah, you know, Mario has coins, Sonic has rings. Well, what the fuck can we give Bubsy? You know, like, if we want this to catch on, if we want those dumb fucking kids, if we want those dumb kids to get their parents to buy more Bubsy games, like, we're gonna have to do something here. You know, we're gonna have to. Bubsy's gotta have his thing, right? You know, he's gotta have something that kids can latch on to. Yarn. That's it, yarn. Yeah, see, Bubsy takes lives, okay? Bubsy ruins lives. Alright, another level. I forgot that, yeah, these... Oh, they make you go through the ringer with each one of these levels. Okay, so, yeah, let's see. What do we got here? Got a Like, in general, I try to stay to the top of the level. Oh, wait, there was a 1-up back there. See, I gotta get the 1-up. You know, if you wonder why I get the 1-ups, well, I'm playing Bubsy. Alright, let's, Oh, hey, look, Isn't that great? Isn't that great?
More like a bridge too short.
You know, and hey, isn't it so great? They, hey, look, they got Bubsy, you know, they got him a few voices, you know, they got him to do a little one-liner at the beginning of every thing. Oh, good, it didn't drop me into the middle of the water this time. Thanks, game. So, okay, like, can I get some momentum going here, and, can I jump up here? No, I can't. That would be fucking silly. Why would the game let me do that? I want to get some momentum going. No, there's just not enough. Oh, almost got me there. Oh, no. But, you know, I would totally love to see a Bubsy reboot. You know, make it happen. Make it happen. Sign a petition today to bring back Bubsy. Because, you know, the kids loved Bubsy. You know, Bubsy was the friend of all children. And, you know, we just want more Bubsy. You know, can't get enough of him. Alright, let's see if I can not die this time. Oh hey, a little life. That's always nice. Am I gonna die here? Yeah, I kinda figured I would.
More like a bridge too short.
Yeah, I know, I went too fast. I mean, I know, right? Like, what do I think I'm doing? Like, what kinda game do I think I'm playing? You're going fast. Like, what the fuck is wrong with me, man? The fuck is wrong with me wanting to go fast? Alright, so here we go. I'm just gonna make some nice easy jumps. It's just, you know, some simple platforming. You know, nothing too bad, nothing too hard. So yeah, now I wanna make that jump, but I don't wanna go too fast. You know, gotta slow down a little bit. I feel like I'm going too fast. Nope, we're at the end. So hey, boss fight. You know, the boss fights, you remember the boss fights from Bubsy, right? Like, those were classic, man. Like, that was classic, classic Bubsy. I mean, they were real fun. See, you just kinda, you just stay in the air and you know, bop into them and that's it. It's kinda, you know, how much can you exploit the air glide, basically. Okay, I got a passcode. Now, I'm not going to use save states, but I will use passcodes. I will use passcodes. And I'm going to actually see if I can beat Bubsy in one sitting, though. Like, okay, if I lose, like, if I lose and, you know, all my continues, everything, that's it for the night, okay? But yeah, like, I'll use a passcode another time, you know? But I want to try to do this. I want to try to beat Bubsy in one sitting, alright? So, one sitting, let's do this. You know, it's time to get bubbed, alright? And so far, at least, I think I'm making decent time on this. Alright, so this, yeah, this can kinda fuck you. Yeah, but, I know you saw that, right? You totally saw that, didn't you? I know you fucking saw it. Alright, how do I get this thing to jump? Oh, look! Look at that! You know? He was right there. So, okay, we have to be careful, okay? Yeah, silly me going for that 1-up, right? I mean, man. I should have known better. I really should have. So, okay, here's what we do. Alright. Yeah, we go up here. We beat the enemy that's guarding that one up, so to speak. Okay, we can't quite get it. Yeah, we're just gonna go up here. Oh, I missed it. I missed it again. Oh. Okay, let's try that again. Let's go for it. There, we got it. You know, because those lives, they mean everything. You know, every Bubsy is precious, okay? Oh, hey, a boot. Yeah, it knocks you backwards. That's fun times. Oh, another one up. Awesome. Oh, yeah, I needed it. I needed that. I want to see Bubsy in more things, you know? Like, Bubsy, he just didn't... You know, Bubsy didn't have enough time to shine, you know? I mean, he totally got cheated out. Got cheated right the fuck out of everything. You know, if it wasn't for that goddamn Mario, that fucking plumber, you know, that fucking plumber and the damn hedgehog. Like, if it weren't for them, Bubsy, he could have been a fucking star. He could have been a rock star, alright? And another death that I completely deserved, because it's my fault for going fast. I realize this, okay? Like, it is entirely my fault for attempting to go fast. I will learn from my mistakes and not commit them again. Alright, don't know where I'm going, but I'm going there. I don't know, can I go fast? Oh god, what's happening? Ugh, end of the level. Yeah, I think I'm doing good so far. I think I'm plugging away just good at this, you know?
Hey, I thought I saw Elvis back there.
Ugh. They're not even jokes. Like, that's the thing. At first I thought they were all puns. But, like, they're not even really puns. They're just... And they're not jokes either. They're just... I don't know what the hell they are. He's just saying things. You know, like, he's just saying things that... I don't know, someone thought was funny, but they're not really, you know? Okay, so, like... Yeah, I realize I'm kind of going too fast here. Yeah, I just, That's nice. Alright, let's get up here. I'm not sure exactly what I did wrong that time, but I did something wrong, you know? I mean, I must have, right? I mean, I said, if anything in this game goes wrong, like if there's a problem or if I die, I did something wrong. It was my fault, okay? So, let's try going up this way. Okay, so what do you want to bet this door takes me backwards? Oh yeah, yeah, fun times. No, I'm not doing that. Yeah, get that damn spider already. Like, if you don't, if you don't assert dominance, it's just gonna make a bitch of you. All right, don't be a spider bitch. All right, just step up. Okay, now, alright, let's try to... Here we go. We're making some progress now. Yeah, I still don't know why I'm going after those yarn balls. I think I've gone over this before, but it's kind of like a compulsive thing, especially with more old-school gamers, I think, is... You know, if there's something that you can collect, you fucking collect it. You know, it doesn't matter if it doesn't do anything, you fucking collect it. Oh, good times. That was a good bonus. Good bonus. So, okay, what's down here? Is it death? No, it's not. I'm surprised. I'm going fast here, you know. I don't know. That's the end of the level. Awesome. Look at that. All the yarn. Because, you know, he's a Bubsy. He's a bobcat. Bobcats like yarn. So, alright, lay the next pun on me. Let's do it.
Shouldn't that be fearless? Uh-oh.
So clever. Okay. Yep.
Uh-oh.
I know. Just a little too fast there. I admit it. I was too fast. Okay, let's kill some of these enemies, because... Okay, this is actually something, like, I don't know that many people kind of realize this, but when you kill the enemies in Bubsy, they do stay dead. Like, I forget what are these things called, like, are they Yarnies or something? I forget, but, like, when you kill them, they don't respawn, so, you know, dead is dead, so it makes getting through the level a little bit easier when you don't have to worry about them, you know, when you respawn and go through it a second time. Like, it makes things just a little bit easier, that second time through. Alright, so, what do you want to bet this kills me? Oh, almost. It almost killed me. It almost got me. But not quite. So, okay, I think we're getting to that point in Bubsy now, where the levels start turning into a bit of a maze. Yeah, see, the levels start turning into a bit of a maze, and yeah, the ice cream cone is the only thing that doesn't kill Bubsy. Like, it's kind of weird. It's like the only thing. Oh, look at that. Oh, Bubsy, you're just so clumsy. Alright, what's through here? That looks like something I don't want to fuck with. It looks like it's something additional, and it's probably only going to be like, hey, get some more yarn. Okay, that's also probably just going to be more yarn. I don't want it, not interested. Can I look down? Okay. Yeah, I don't want to get lost in this maze forever. So I'm taking what I believe is the most direct route. But oh look, I was wrong. Is there anything up there, or is that... No, that's just the wall. Okay, so this is clearly the right way to go. So do I want to go through, like, what's in the store? A crate full of tacks and bananas. Great. So you slip on the bananas and you run into the tacks. Awesome. Okay, so let's kill all these things. Yep. Alright. Now this should be the way out. Or not. So do I want to go fast? Do I want to risk going fast here? Probably not, because look, that happens.
Shouldn't that be fearless? Uh-oh.
I guess maybe I hesitated, right? I hesitated, and that's why I died. Alright, but I know the way to go now, right? Now that hot dog, that doesn't... Yeah, that responds. Okay, yeah, again, that's the bullshit. Alright, this is the right way to go. Yeah, then you get over here and you are met with more bullshit. which is fine, you know. So, yeah, you don't want to go down there, you want to go over here. And, yeah, you don't want to hesitate, you just want to go for it there. Get that one up. Because I do need those one-ups. I constantly need them. And, hey, what do you want to bet they're going to kill me here? Oh, no. I'm fucking checkpointing that shit. Yeah, I'm fucking checkpointing that shit. Okay, so... yeah. Okay, that's that. Yeah, excellent, excellent fun times. Alright. Oh, that's what they're called. They're, yeah, they're called woolies. I forgot about that. So, okay, yeah, this level, oh man, I remember this. yeah, so these levels are actually divided up into two levels. Like, they're actually twice as long as they appear to be. Which, you know, that's fun. Yeah, I would honestly say the only boss in this game that's a problem, like the only one that could actually kill you, right? The only one that actually has any sort of chance of actually killing you is probably the final boss. The final boss is actually a little bit challenging, a little bit. But if you can get it in a pattern, like if you can get it stuck in a pattern, yeah, no, you can kill it just like anything else. Oh, look at those giraffes with... like, I bet they have sneakers on, too, don't they? Oh, yeah, look at that. Look at that, you got giraffes with, you know, sneakers and shades on. Like, oh, man, they are... those giraffes are 90s cool. They are 90s cool. So, yeah, I want to go fast again, but, you know, I know what happens when I go fast. Alright, man, I really want to stop getting this yarn, because it really is slowing, you know, it's slowing me down, you know, the constant quest for yarn, right? Makes the levels go on longer than they need to go on, but at the same time, I can't help myself, like, I can't stop myself, I have to do it, I gotta get the yarn. So yeah, level over, right? No. Each level has two parts, so, yeah, you know, you finish that up, on to the next level. Now, if I remember right, I thought there was a secret over there. My bad. Yeah, the only secret back there is death. The secret of Bubsy is death, yes. So let's continue, shall we? Let's not worry about that. So yeah, the thing about this level that you gotta watch out for is the cactus. Yeah, the cactus will kill you dead. And it's so easy. It is so goddamn easy to run into the cactus. Like that. You know, when you build up momentum, you can't really stop. So, that's fun. So yeah, I'm gonna inch my way along here. I'm not worrying about the secrets. I know they're secrets. I know... but I'm trying to keep a good pace. Oh, slippery Bubsy. So slippery. So slippery. Okay, I'm gonna try to do this... like, I'm really trying to control my jumps, you know? Like, I'm trying to jump in a way that... like, it doesn't make him accelerate too much, but it's very difficult to do that. Yeah, Bubsy's always sliding around. Oh, look at that. Yeah, look at that. I went too fast. I went too fast again. Guys, I went a little too fast. Whoa, like it came from the top that time. Oh, hey, there's two of them. You thought there was only one rock? No, there's two of them. Man, all my continues, my poor, poor continues. And see, you can't quite go too fast there either, because, yeah. Alright, so that's the, you know, that's the checkpoint. Good times. Alright, fun times, fun, so fun times. Okay, I was on top of it, right? Like, I know I was on top of the damn thing, right? Oh, look. Yeah, look at me. I'm going fast. I gotta stop that. Like, I wanna go fast, though. I really wanna go fast, okay? But I'm trying hard to restrain myself. You know, I'm trying to resist the urge. It's a very strong urge, though. Like, I really do wanna go fast. I mean, yeah, like, see, look at that. I want to go fast, but then that happens. You know, something just flies off from out of, you know, from off screen, and you have no chance to avoid it like that. Yeah, so, a lot of Bubsy is just kind of trial and error. You know, it's trial and error, and you have to know, like, you have to know when to go fast and when not to go fast, right? It's like, okay, I'm gonna go slow right here. I'm gonna go real fucking slow. Alright. Yeah, and that's the end of the level. Good times. So I'm getting there, you know, I'm making progress. I'm down to one life. Like, I somehow went through, like, I went through, like, 10 lives in that level. But hey, that's Bubsy. You know, you gotta roll with it. You know, you gotta roll with the Bubs, right? And Bubs rolls deep, he rolls real deep. So, just gotta have those lives ready to go. Now, I forget if lives, like if the little life t-shirts respawn or not. If they do, I might be able to exploit that to my advantage in one of these levels, but if they don't, if the shirts don't respawn, then it's gonna make this game a lot harder. I mean, you know, it wasn't hard enough yet. Okay, we got a checkpoint. Good stuff, good stuff. Okay, there's that life up. So here's what I wanted to know. Yeah, I wanna know if the life shirts, if they respawn or not, so... No, the life shirts do not respawn. They do not respawn. So I can't exploit that or anything. Well, that's a shame. Wow, I picked the wrong time to jump. It really is all about memorizing levels. You know, it's about memorizing when exactly to jump and when not to jump. You know, when do you jump, when do you not jump, when do you go fast, when do you go slow? Because sometimes, you know, sometimes when you go slow, sometimes when you go slow, you actually die because you went too slow, right? So it's just kind of like this, it's this very fine art that you have to get good at knowing when is the right time and when is the wrong time. Alright, hey, we got a black shirt. Not exactly sure what those do or not. Like, I'm not sure if that's, I don't think it's invincibility. Like, what it does is I think the enemies don't notice you. Like, you can walk through the enemies when you get the black shirt. But, yeah, like, if you... You'll still get killed by things, you know, like, you'll still get killed by attacks. So let's see. You know, last time I went left, I died. So let's see if there's anything over there this time. Like, I mean, there's got to be a secret over here one of these times, right? Yeah, some yarn. So awesome. I got a little bit of yarn. Good times. There's lots of cactus. You know, in case you didn't get enough of that. Oh, I died. Okay, so I got 2 continues. See, I'm going until I run out of continues. So, I get 9 more lives, and yeah, let's do this. Let's you know, we're going deep. We're gonna beat Bubsy. Okay, now this is a secret, right? This looks like a secret. This feels like a secret, but I don't want it. I actually don't want this secret because look at that. You know, I went for the secret, and I died. Yeah, I went for the secret and died. And that's kind of the thing about this game, is that, like, the secrets are just as likely to kill you as to give you anything good. I mean, like, half the time, you'll die several times trying to get, like a one-up or something, right? Okay, there's a shark in the ground. I don't see anything wrong with that. Alright, we got a checkpoint. Okay, that was a secret of some kind. I'm not exactly sure, like, what it was, but it was a secret, whatever it was. Okay, this is a secret. I said I wasn't gonna follow the secrets, right? But it was a checkpoint, and I want checkpoints, okay? Oh, that's lovely. Oh, great. Just right. I have a real knack for landing just in the wrong way. So, okay. Yeah, let's progress. Let's get some progress in here. Now, yeah, see, I saw this guy throwing his eggs. I don't know why eggs are their thing. Like, I don't know why they throw eggs. I mean, it doesn't really... Like, I don't know, they're these weird guys that collect yarn, right? It's like, I don't know how that fits into their whole theme. Oh, look, I landed right on a cactus. That's the great thing about Bubsy, you just never know where you're gonna land. You never know what's coming, you know? Like, you think you're ready, but you're not. You're never quite ready for what Bubsy has to throw at you. Oh, look! I thought, hey, maybe I'll go a little early. Nope. Okay, so let's make this little jump here. Okay, so I can see exactly where I need to go this time. The camera is kind of funny like that, you know? Alright, so is this the end of the level? It looks like it. Yeah, that's the end of the level. All the yarn. Oh boy, we get another one of these delightful stages, and you know, of course it's a two-parter, they're all two-parters, so... Alright, we got a one-up, let's get this shirt right here. Again, I don't really know exactly what this shirt does, I think it just keeps enemies from killing you on contact, but I think you still die, like if you get hit with an attack. I think that's how that works. If anyone knows better, you know, feel free to say so, but I think that's how it works. Wait a minute, is there... I think... Yeah, I'm gonna go for it. Yeah, so that wasn't a total waste, you know? Okay, hold on. There's something up there. Oh, crap. Okay, I thought it was gonna, like, drop me down into a spike pit or something, because that's the kind of game this is, you know? Banana crates. I mean, you know, because the game wasn't, you know, didn't have slippery enough controls as it is. Okay, just, man, I have to concentrate just to not die, like, every 2 seconds in Bubsy. Okay, now, I feel like there's gotta be something over here, right? They wouldn't just, you know, there's like a life up, there's a one up over here, right? There's something over here, right? There's gotta be something. No, there's nothing over there except, you know, some things that might kill you, so let's just get the fuck away from that. Look at that. You know, if I was just one pixel off, I would have gotten killed by that spike thing. There's way too many levels. That's how many levels there are in Bubsy. There are way too fucking many, okay? I think that will accurately answer your question. But, like, to answer it another way, so, like, I know that, like, technically, like, you know, each one of these stages, because there's two parts, it's like you're going through six levels, right? But these only count as three levels, actually. Yeah, like, each one of these whole, like, train and canyon stages, each one only counts as one level, even though they're actually, like, you know, they're two levels in one. They really only count as one, so, Okay, there's three of those things there now. There's my opportunity, and another checkpoint, and please let this be the end of the level, and it is not the end of the level. Foolish of me. A foolish player for me to think that this was the end of the level. Oh, crap. I didn't want to go down there. Just let me out. Okay, good. Like, see, I know that was a secret. Like, that's kind of the funny thing. Like, in any other game, you'd be like, ooh, a secret! I want that! No, you don't want the secrets in this. So yeah, let's just, you know, let's make a joke of the level again, of the boss. Yep, fun times, right? Yeah, now I'm trying to remember, like, what the next, theme level is. Cause I'm having a hard time remembering, like, exactly how many levels there are, actually. But, okay, like, I know that the last level is space. Okay, like, the last level is in space. Yeah, like, these great outdoors levels here, yeah, these great outdoors levels, there's, like, three of those. So, like, there's three levels of this. And then there's, like, a jungle level. Like, there's, like, three levels of jungle. And then there's the space level. So I think there's, like, maybe, you know... There's maybe, like, seven levels left. Maybe more if there's more than one space level. I forget. Like, I forget if there's, three space levels or just one. I honestly can't remember. But yeah, that's a good idea of how many levels there are to go. I mean, it's entirely doable to do it in one sitting. Like... It's kind of on the long side, you know. It is kind of on the long side, like especially if you're dying constantly. But no. The game's not that long. Okay, let's see if I can get up here, right? Oh, look, that doesn't go forward. That goes backwards. That puts me at the beginning of a level again. Okay. And also, yeah. Oh, too many levels, too fucking many levels. So yeah, I don't want to go up there. Like it would actually be a bad thing for me to go up there because it's just gonna take me backwards. Like, yes, I see the goddamn secret door. Okay, like I see the secret door. I'm not blind. I swear it. And something killed me.
Yeah, I didn't like that stuff.
All right, but oh, look at that. There's a two-up shirt back there. What's the catch? What's the catch, right? What's the fucking catch, Bubsy? Oh, that's the catch. Yeah, the whole bottom of the floor is water. That's the catch to the level, right? So let me try to be real careful. No, you know what? I'm not gonna go for it. Like, I know, there's a secret, there's one-ups, there's bonus content, but I'm not gonna go for it, alright?
Yeah, I didn't like that stuff.
Like, look, if I lose all my lives, I can use a password, okay? You know, if I lose every single one of my fucking lives, I can use a password, and that'll take me back to where I am. Yeah, what... Oh, crap, I didn't mean to do that, but yeah, I'm not gonna go for the secrets, the bonuses. They're only gonna fuck me in the end. So, yeah, let's take this nice and slow. Well, as slow as we can, because, you know, Bubsy. Okay, let's see. Gotta be very careful here. What's underneath of me? Okay. Alright, we're doing it. We're doing it. Hey, look, a checkpoint. I needed that. Good thing I got that checkpoint, isn't it? Alright, let's do this and do it right this time. You know, I hadn't really mentioned it before, but like the hitboxes for the enemies, right? The hitboxes are not quite, I don't know. There's something off about them. Like, the hitboxes don't quite function the way you think they should. Like, sometimes you'll hit an enemy. Oh, look at that. I was so close. But yeah, like, sometimes you'll hit an enemy and, like, it'll be dead on, but you'll die. And then other times, like, you'll jump underneath the enemy, which, like, that should be a guaranteed you're fucked, right? But no, you'll come out of it just fine. So it's just kinda, it's odd, you know, like, how things work in Bubsy is not, it doesn't always work like you think it should. But hey look, I'm fucking invincible now. I'm fucking invincible. You know, I can fucking do anything I want now. Come on, Bubsy, don't. Alright, here we go. There's another checkpoint right there. Alright, so, oh, no, you don't want to go up there. That's anti-progress over there.
Yeah, I didn't like that.
Well, that was fun. So, yeah, you might notice that, like, when I go up, that's actually the reverse of progress. Like, you're not supposed to go up here. You're supposed to kind of, I don't know. You're supposed to stay low. But like, mostly what I'm trying to do is I want to stay in control, okay? Like, the thing is that when Bubsy, like, when he gets out of control, you know, like when he starts bouncing all over the fucking place, yeah, like, or you know, that happens, it causes problems. So, did that drain the water? Because I think that's a mechanic in this level. No, that did not drain the water. In fact, that seems to have made it go higher. So, we don't want that. Oh god, that was... Like, it's actually, like, you know, you want spooks, like, this is the real horror game. Like, you know, Bubsy. Bubsy is the true horror. Because... Like, I'm always so afraid. I'm so very afraid that Bubsy's gonna just get himself killed, and then I'm gonna have to redo everything, and... Yeah, it's a different kind of horror. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what to call it, but it's something different. So yeah, the end of the level is not. It's not down there. It's up. So like, even though up has been, you know, like up isn't a good thing, right? Well, guess what? Up is a good thing now. Yeah, the levels start getting less linear at this point. Yeah, it's kind of right here. It's like, it's this stage where the levels stop being go left to right. I mean, yeah, you still want to go left to right, but the end of the stage, sometimes the end of the stage might be like at the very top of the stage, it might be at the bottom, or it might be somewhere in the middle. Like, you don't know. You don't know where the end of the stage is. All you know is that it's on the right side of the map, right? But you don't know where on the right side of the map. Oh, hey, that kills me, huh? I got one more continue. I got one more continue. So let's, yeah, let's try to do this on one continue, alright? Let's beat Bubsy. And I mean, if not, hey, I got passwords, right? Passwords are your friend. So what's up there? I don't know. I don't know, and it's probably gonna kill me, whatever it is. Like that, see? You know, whenever you don't know, whenever you don't know what's coming, assume that it's gonna kill you. There's just certain laws of Bubsy that you have to follow, if you wanna play Bubsy. You know, and don't go, again, don't go fast. I know you wanna go fast, but don't do that shit. Don't go fast. Like, look at that. There were like two kinds of death that could have happened to me right there. So yeah, that looks like a lot of death. Let's just go around that. Alright. Also, I love how there's crocodiles in the water. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense. I mean, you know, if you get in the water, you're fucking dead. So I guess it's just you're extra dead. Oh, hey, look. There was a checkpoint, but I didn't quite make it. I didn't quite make it to the checkpoint. Alright, some concentration, some focus here. Oh, I got killed again. Next time, I get a It's just right off camera, you know? Like, you know it's coming, right? But it's just a little bit off camera, so you're not quite sure. Okay, so let's be careful. Like, let's not jump this time. Like, let's stay on the ground this time. Okay, there we go. Okay, that. You know, again, I talk about the hitboxes, and that totally should have fucking killed me, right? That totally should have fucking murdered the fuck out of me. But it didn't. Like, I hit him from a side angle, and it was okay. Alright, let's warm up for a big Bubsy jump. Yeah, you know how well those Bubsy jumps go. Next time, I get a stunt cat. Oh, Bubsy. Oh, Bubsy. Okay, so we want to watch out for the crocodiles this time. Oh, hey, the water isn't drained out of there. That's nice. Alright, so this time, let's just make a big ol' leap. Okay, we're doing it, we're doing it, we're doing it! Alright. We are making the progress. It's scary, because like, I'm making progress, and I'm like, oh god, what's gonna go wrong? What's gonna fucking go wrong? You know, how is Bubsy going to rob me of progress today? How's he gonna do it? And also, like, I know for a fact that you have to go. Like, the end of the level isn't going to be on the bottom. It's not going to be on the bottom of the stage. It's going to be up here somewhere. Next time, I get a stunt cat. Okay, we got three lives to do this with. Excellent.
Next time, I get a stunt cat.
So we got two lives to do this. Let's fucking do it. All right. I'm gonna jump on top of those things this time. I'm not gonna let them get underneath of me. All right. So just stay in the air, I think, is the plan here. All right. Is this it? This is the end of the stage. Okay. All right. I think there's like one more of these. There's one more of these great outdoors levels, and I think that's it. Alright, let's do this. I think I can do this on two lives? On one life? Think I can do this on one life?
Is there a veterinarian in the audience?
I think I can, alright? I think I can. I definitely think I can. I have positivity on my side. Alright, which fucking way do I want to go here? Not sure, but I'm gonna assume there might be an extra life up here, maybe? I don't know. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Well, that's it. That's it for the Bubsy. But hey, I got my continues, right? I got my continues, so, you know, I can... Or, not continues, I got my, passwords. Also, I forget how you, you hit the select button. Hey, look, who's the creators of Bubsy?
What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, you don't want to tell me, do you? No, you hit the start button and it just makes the game start up. Well, I think that's enough Bubsy for tonight, though. I'll do it again, you know. I'll do it again, and I'll do it all the way through, alright? But no, not tonight. But that's just kind of something we can work on, right? You know, we can work on that as we go. Let's see what time. It's 11:34. What have I got? Well, I got some games that I could try, but nah, I haven't really set them up yet. I know. How about one more arcade game, right? Let's do one more arcade game. I've tried it once before on the stream. It's pretty fun. It's a pretty fun, good game. I don't think my controller will work for it though. So I think I have to use the keyboard for it. Controller won't work. But that's okay. That's okay. It is okay. Let's do this. Let's do this. Just un momento here. As I close that out. Okay, this is gonna be a great way to close things out. Let's go to the full screen, and we gotta do a game capture. And hey, look, it's already up on the game capture. That's good. That's good. So here it is, and it should be in glorious full screen now. Not sure if anyone's, you know, if you're familiar with this one, but it's a good game. It's a hard game, but it's a good game. And I'm definitely not gonna beat it tonight. I'm gonna tell you that right now. But I'm gonna try. I'm gonna try my hardest. Maldita Castilla. All right, and yeah, the controller don't work. So let's just pop that out. I wish the controller worked because it would make things a lot easier. It really would. But okay, keyboard time. We're all about the keyboard. This is a PC game, so you know, keyboard it up. Alright, so we start off in Tolomera del Rey. Very, very Espanol themed game. And I'm sure that anyone, I'm sure that you can guess what this game is based on. You know, like what its inspiration was. It's pretty easy to see. It wears it right on its sleeve. So you get to hear my my keyboard movements, but that's because, can't use the controller for this. It's something like that. It's Maldita Castilla! straight from España. Basically, just kind of think of it as a Spanish, think of it like a, like Spanish Ghosts and Goblins. No, it's actually not. This is its own unique game. It's inspired by Ghosts and Goblins, but it isn't Ghosts and Goblins. What this kind of pulls on is there's a lot of kind of Spanish folklore and fiction that it builds off of. That's where the story and the themes of the game come from, but. Yeah, again, it looks like what it looks like. I know. But I like this game. It's kind of bullshit at times, but it's still a lot of fun. I like the music for the boss fights especially. Alright, so yeah, boss one, not a problem. Very easy. And here's our first little power-up. It's a fairy that, shoots orbs out. Yeah, this game doesn't hold back with the gore. You'll be seeing lots of gore spread out in the game. Alright, got the crown. Good times. I don't need that, because I have a better weapon. Oh yeah, you're gonna be running into that later. Oh yeah, it's boss time. And you'll hear lots of clicky clacking on that keyboard, because again, PC doesn't even take a controller. Like, you can't even use a controller even if you got one. It's a shame. Like, that would've, if this game had controller support, it would've made it perfect. And for God and Castile! I love it every single time. Alright, now this is a fun little stage here. Alright, so the guys on the carriage, they will actually, they'll try to help out, they'll get a kill in every now and then. And that's good, because this would be a lot harder if they didn't help a little bit. But, you know, you still gotta really watch your ass, because if you get knocked off, you have to use up one of your lives, and that's no fun. Got that concentration going. Oh shit. Quesada, no! So yeah, Quesada's gone now. And of course we won't run into him later. Of course not. Yeah, so just, you know, on this part, you just try really hard not to get knocked off. Alright. Alright, so we'll meet up with them in the forest level. And I got one heart, so of course I'll make it. Yeah, I'll be there. Oh hey, just what I needed. Just what I needed. Let's see, I want to keep the fairy here. Also, while it's on my mind, the game's not too loud, is it? Because I haven't said it or anything. Like, I said it once before. I'm not sure if the sound will carry over or not. So just tell me if it's too loud, like, compared to me. I mean, really, I love the music in this game. And I want people to hear the music. Like, I definitely want people to hear that music. Because it is good. And the sound effects, too. Everything is very well done in this game. And for this, it's like, no, the game is the important thing to be looking at and hearing. Alright, that's good, that's good. I guess it must have remembered what I set it to before. Good, good, good. So yeah, okay, here's where we get into some precision platforming. This is not the first, won't be the last. There will be precision platforming. That's a big thing in this game. And you kind of have to know, like, you have to know when to jump. If you don't know when to jump, you'll just kind of die. Alright, time for another boss fight. And this is a tricky but fun one. Oh no, oh no. I don't want to get knocked off of this thing. Alright, the trick to these fights is you kind of want to keep it moving. Like, you want to kill them fast before they have much of a time to do anything. And oh shit! Oh shit. Yeah, so look at that. I killed him. But then I fell off the cloud, so yeah, like you can't rest. Like there's no resting, there's no relaxing. You know, you have to keep things moving. Yeah, you do not want to ever relax in this game. Never. Not even when you've beaten the boss. Like, no, the boss can still kill you. You can still fucking die. Even after the boss is dead, you can still die. Alright, so see, this time, I want to be very careful. There you go. Yeah, so... For God and Castile! Ah, get you pumped each time. Alright, so now we get an interlude, Plague Dance. So yeah, there's bonus stages here. Yeah, I lost the good weapon, but honestly, like, there's really no bad weapons in this game. Like, that's kind of the thing. It's not like Ghosts and Goblins in the sense that there are no bad weapons. Like, all the weapons are fairly good. Alright, so let's storm the castle, shall we? Ooh, thought I could jump it, but no. Oh, great. Yeah, so that boss, he's back, but he's just a regular old enemy now. Okay, good. I got a good weapon, but you know, how long do you think I'm gonna be able to hold on to that? Oh man, I got caught on the stairs. Yeah, I got caught on the stairs and couldn't move. Ugh. Embarrassing. Gotta be a little bit careful here. Well, you know, it's a good game. More people should know about this. More people should do this game. I think it's, I'm trying to remember the, studio name it made this, or, studio, but it's like, it's one guy, it's like, Loco Melito. I think Loco Melito is the name of the, person who makes these. And they're all, he's got a bunch of games like this and more, and they're just free on the website, so, you know, if you want to play this or something like it, like, yeah, just, you know, do some Googling. It's all free. And I have to say, like, for a free game, I mean, it'd be, honestly, he could've gotten this up on Steam, you know, like, shit, get it on Steam so we have some good retro games on there. Alright, so I got a key, I think this falls into the territory of secrets, so... Yes, I found the key, so now I have to go through this. Fun times, just a little, you know, just a little precision. And just jump down here. It's a little hard, but man, I like it. I really like it. And everything about this game is just fun. You know, the visuals, the music, even the difficulty. It's all fun. It's all in good fun. I don't think I need to kill this dragon here, but it would be a lot of fun if I do. Yeah, there we go. Some wall harpies. And I guess it makes sense. Not the anything about the enemies in the game needs to make sense. Okay, so we can't go to the left yet. So let's go to the right. And of course the skeletons explode. Why wouldn't they? Alright, we'll just wait for that to go by again. Satisfying skeleton explosion. Okay, so I want to get that guy, but yeah, when he explodes, like when they explode, it's kind of inconvenient. Yeah, see, it's kind of inconvenient when they explode like that. Although, wait a minute, I just kind of realized I have a key, don't I? I have a key. That key could totally be used on this door over here, couldn't it? Like, it would totally let me go through it, wouldn't it? So let's try that. Like, I didn't even... Yeah, okay, so... Yeah, the key that I've got that lets me go back there. See, I was not even thinking about it. And hey, look, we got one of Mora's tears. It's great. It's excellent. Yeah, like, as I remember it, if you want to get the true ending of the game, you know, the final level true ending, you kind of need to have all of the tears. If you don't get all the tears... yeah, you're kind of fucked. And I love that boss design, huh? Just a bearded scorpion thing. Man, my aim. Alright, but yeah, that wasn't the boss. That was just a little mini-boss. Just a pathetic little mini-boss. And you thought you were a real man for beating that boss. No, not at all. Okay, so, yeah, the thing about this is, yeah, you get hit, you get knocked back. Like, you really, really fucking get knocked back, so... Alright, so yeah, I want to kill these faces. I don't want them to, I really, really don't want them to hit me on the way up. Because that would be bad. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Yeah, it's real easy to just get hit. But... You know, I'm trying to work them down here so that, just trying to work these things down a little bit. So that, yeah, all I have to worry about is that one now. Oh! I almost had that shield. Almost. But that's okay. Yeah, now let's try a different tactic, alright? Let's try the run like a bitch tactic, alright? I think it's quite effective, too. Yeah, just run and don't stop. It works. There we go. Yeah, see, run and don't stop. It works. I really, really wish I could use a controller for this. It would make, it'd be a lot less awkward than the, control scheme that they kinda... to give you to work with in this. What's in this? Ah, invincibility. Yeah, I'll take some of that. Oh, that you thought that invincibility? No, you thought that would let you get through the fire? No, that would be silly. Yeah. Also, you can't die too many times in this game. Like. You can die quite a few times, but if you use up your continues, like, like, I think 4 times might be the number. Yeah, if you have to use a continue 4 times, no, it's just game over. Or not, you know, it's not game over, it's, you're done, like, you can't get the good ending anymore, which, you know, for my purposes, like, that pretty much is game over, right? Because if you can't get the good ending, then what are you even doing? Alright, so yeah, boss, it's Tin Man Don Quixote. Yeah, crazy Quixote. That, sure, why not? So yeah, you can only hit him when he's on fire, so if he's not on fire, can't do any damage. And this boss is fairly easy, just, it's... Sometimes you'll get caught up in his, you get in a bad position every now and then, and when that happens, there's really not a lot you can do about it. So just try not to get in a bad position. You know, try not to get cornered too much. There we go. It happened. But hey, look, you start right at the boss, which is always convenient. And again, can't hit him unless he's on fire, so... Yeah, see, when he does that spin, you kind of just want to be down there. If you're over to the corners, you'll just take a lot of damage. So, nice, do that. And then, Alright, and it's probably gonna be the knives, so... Yeah, see, if I just sit here, I'm good. And it's just kind of wait until he's done. Wait till he's done going crazy, basically. And I should be able to take him out when he comes back down. Yeah, so let's just get all the knives in. And yeah, that last bit of fire there, yeah, that can totally kill you. And for God and Castile, again. So far I'm doing decently. I haven't used a single continue yet, but that's gonna change. I'm telling you right now, that's gonna change. The Swamp of Malaventure, I'm gonna assume it's the Swamp of Bad Adventure. Okay, so yeah, wait for these to open up. And more of that delicious good music, too. Soak in the atmosphere. I love those little bugs that, they're little bugs with faces on them. Now, I could stay here swatting flies all day, but not a lot of point to that. This game does, that's the only thing I don't really like, is that every now and then the game requires some very, very precision jumping and, yeah, like some precision jumping and, you know, jump shooting and, gets a little bit of a hassle there. And I don't mean platforming bad, I mean, you have to really, like, get it 100% perfect or you die. See, like, I missed that. And I died. I don't like how the game relies a little bit too much on that kind of precision. Because there's a certain amount of precision where it's like, you have to have a little wiggle, you know? If you have no wiggle room at all, it just kind of... I don't know. So is this a weapon? Yes. Now I want to wait. There's a weapon I want out of this. Come on, give me the one I want. That one. Yeah, this weapon, it really helps to deal with that whole precision problem. There's some dinosaur bones, I mean, why not? Yeah, see, now I don't have to worry about precision so much. So I guess it's a real good thing to, you know, keep your upgrades. And of course, mermaids! Yes, mermaids! They are out for blood. Just out for fucking blood. I'll take some more time. Why not? Alright, boss fight time. Alright, one more, and we'll be good. Yep, easy enough. And it's just a little turtle. But yeah, no, that's not the boss of the level. That's not the boss of the level. So yeah, we got a little helper here who's gonna light our way. Yeah, it's one of these sections where, you can't see anything. Alright, so let's try not to die. Alright, now as I recall, there's some secrets I need to get around here. Like, they may seem optional, but they're not optional. Oh, crap. Okay, so yeah, I need to be careful here. I just want to kill this so it doesn't knock out my my light. Alright, see, not so bad. We got another one of Mora's tears. You know, we need those too. So now, I just try not to. Oh, yeah, gotta try not to get hit by things, right? Right? That's all I had to do, right? Was just, you know, not get hit by things. I don't know if I can get over that or not. Like, how's my jump? How's my verticality, right? I don't think I have the verticality for that. But I can't go under it either, so it's kind of, you know, you lose no matter what. Alright. Okay, see that? That's some of that precision platforming right there. Alright, just gotta. Oh, see, look, now I can't see anything. Yeah, this is quite an annoying little section here. But hey, at least I got the Mora's tier for this area. I have to be honest here, I've never beaten this game yet. Like, I haven't beaten it yet because I haven't really played it that much. I've only played it a very little bit. So, like, I probably, you know, I won't be able to guess where every single one of the tiers are. It's like I'll probably miss that, right? Alright, now here we go, and, alright, where's the boss? Oh, it's a trap! Yes, it is a trap. Our helpful little imp friend is not helpful. He is not our friend. He's out to kill us just like every single other monster that we've encountered in the game. Surprise. Shock of all shocks. Yeah, here's the real boss. Here's the real, here's the real final boss of the stage here. Now, I've always, like, this boss has always, it's given me problems. I don't know, like, I've always found it very hard to hit this boss and not get hit at the same time. Like, I know there's a pattern here. Oh, that was incredibly stupid of me. But yeah, like, I know that there's a pattern, and it's a pretty easy pattern. It's just I have to kind of catch on to it again. But yeah, see, now I don't have my nice little power-up, so I have to try not to get hit. So I need to do very, very precise shooting here. Okay, so we're back to where we were. Can we hit him when he... No, can't hit him then. Yeah, it's like he, all the bullets have sort of a weird curve to them. But I mean, it's very predictable. Like, the curve pattern that they're on, it's a very predictable pattern. It's just really, I think what kind of gets you is you, you want to get more hits in than is really a good idea. So, like, you tend to get greedy here, right? Like, you'll get greedy for those hits. And, it makes you take more damage than you should otherwise. Yeah, see, it's not hard at all, it's easy to get greedy, and you get greedy, you get dead. Yeah, so not too hard there, but, you know. Yeah, I like the bosses. I like all the bosses, I like all the levels. I mean, this game is just pure fun. Oh yeah, like, what, like the terror mask? Okay, so we get another little bonus stage. No, it's a fun little bonus. Oh no, my bonuses are fading. Okay, well, I got a heart, so that's good. Alright, the Cursed Forest, that's where we're supposed to meet all the other adventurers, the conquistadors, went ahead of us, so... Surely that'll work out just fine, right? Now, again, I don't know where all the Mora's tiers are, so, like, I'm probably... If there's one in this level, I'm probably gonna miss it. I'm saying it right now, and that's okay. It's okay, because I could use the practice at this game anyway. I could use the practice, so, you know, no problem going over it again. And goddamn, I love it how all the giant lizards in this game, they all have, like, red hair and beards. It's great. Alright, so what's up here? So, okay, so what I do remember about this level is it's a bit of a maze. There's a tree thing. You know, let's just not even worry about that. Let's just, yeah, let's just keep going. So do we want to go up or down? Okay, so you kind of have to remember the order, so let's try up. Up was not the right answer. It was not the right answer at all. Up was not the right answer. Not one single bit. Yeah, so we went up, and that was not a good idea. So down. We want to go down at that door. I still love the music here, though. Like, I'm still addicted to the music in this game. Yeah, so these things explode into a bunch of little ones. If you don't have the, if you don't have the power up here, like, oh, not fun. Not very fun at all. Yeah, see, if you don't have the fairy and this weapon, oh, man. So, okay, first door was down. We went down on the first one. So, down, up. Okay, so down, up. That's the order. Down, up. I already got a weapon. I don't need that one. Down, up. Okay, so I'm gonna guess down, up, down, right? That seems like a... It seems like the, thing to do here. So down, up... Yeah, down, up, down. So, okay, so down, up, down. Alright, I'm just kinda, you know, I'm just kinda repeating it so I don't, you know, I don't wanna forget. So down, up, down... And oh, look, I happen to have a key. So down, up, down, down again. Down, up, down, down, up, down, down. And hey, it's boss time. Mendoza! No, not you too! Mendoza! No, even Mendoza, even Mendoza. So this is kind of fun. They make you fight like... Yeah, gonna deal with these things. Alright, got Mendoza. Oh, but there's more! You thought that was it. No, there's more. Alright, yeah, so we just killed all of our fellow conquistadors, and we've buried them in the forest. So time to proceed. And also, like, I like how, if you look at the trees here, like, you can see that, like, there's weird, like, it looks like there's, like, people fused into the tree up there at the top, on both sides. It's kind of a neat little thing. I love that art style. Yeah, all the boss fights are pretty damn fun. So, okay, this level, like, I won't lie, I've only really gotten as far as this in the game. And the reason is that this level right here, I always lose all of my, lives on this level. I don't know, like, something about this level, it's just the difficulty in the pitfalls. It's a little bit nuts. It's a little bit nuts. But as I understand it, like, there is kind of a, there's a trick to it, right? There's a kind of a little exploit that you can do to kind of get through this, and I'm going to try to make use of that. I've only seen it employed, I have not done it myself, so we'll see how that goes down. Okay, yeah, see, like, I try to go down there, and, it just doesn't seem to go well for me, right? Oh no. See, okay, that's the problem. See that right there? That's the problem with this, with this whole thing. Yeah, you get hit, and you pretty much, you get hit, you just fall. You fall straight into the spikes, and you can't stop yourself, you know? You cannot stop falling. It's kind of ridiculous. But I think that there is kind of a way around that whole thing. I'm gonna try it this time, alright? I wasn't sure where it was, but... Okay, so here's what I know, alright? Is you go down, right? And you let yourself get hit. And you try not to do that. You try not to do that. But yeah, like what I was gonna say is that you let yourself get hit there, right? And it knocks you to the right. But here's the thing, if you do it right, like if you're in just the right position, what should happen there is that it'll knock you onto that ledge, and you can kill the enemy there, and then you can just fall down. You know, you have a nice easy shot to the end of the level. That's if you do it right. If you do it wrong, then, you know, like what just happened, you just die. Let's see if I can pull it off, though. Like, Oh! What? How did I even... Okay, like, I'm sure that you all saw that. Like, I just fell down into the spikes. Like, it didn't hurt me. Now I'm curious if that's a bug, or if, like, I can replicate that. And yeah, there's a... Man, death everywhere in here. But hey, you know, it is a, you know, it is kind of, you know, a Spanish, you know, España game, so... They do tend to have that theme, you know, the whole death theme. Okay, so let's see if I can exploit this right. Yeah, like, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get knocked into the wall here. Like, I'm trying to get knocked... Like, no, it's not working for me. It's not working for me that time. So, I don't know. Like, that was kind of my plan. Like, I'll say it right now, my plan was to, my plan was to get knocked over onto the ledge there so that I don't have to, you know, I don't have to worry about the other one, but that doesn't seem like it's going to be an option. So this time, let's try, Now, you saw how I landed on the spikes and I didn't die, right? So let's see if I can replicate that. Like, if I can't, it's okay. You know, it's just to continue. At this point, I don't think I have... Like, I think I missed some of the tears of Mora. So, like, I don't think I even have a chance at, you know, at beating the game. But, you know, but... Yeah, oh, let's see if we can do this. Let's see if we can, yeah, if we can kind of, Oh, no, couldn't do that. That's odd. See, like, I'm really trying to think, like, okay, how am I gonna get down there, right? I don't see a good way down there, I really don't. Yeah, this level, it's pretty much, it's like, it's this level that has always just killed me. Just killed the fuck out of me. I can't get past it. I wish I knew how to get past it, but I can't. Like, I've tried to exploit it, tried to do it legit, but there just doesn't really seem to be a good way to get down there. That's really where I'm struggling. Like, So let's try this time, right? No, I swear that I've seen someone, like, do this and, like, basically they got hit and they... It launched them past the spikes. I don't know how to do it, though. Like, I guess I'm not good enough. I gotta get good, right? Yeah, I'm clearly not good enough for that kind of thing. So, let's try something a little different. I'm basically just trying to find a good tactic. Like, I'm not really trying to beat the game right yet. I'm just trying to find, like, good strategies to get through each level without dying a lot. You know... Even if I have to exploit a little bit, that's fine, but, Okay, so there's the other bubble. I'm just gonna pop that. Okay, so now we go down. Man. Yeah, see, those bubbles, like, they come out of everywhere. Okay, so let's try the exploit, I guess. Yeah, this is, like, it's one of those things where I feel like I must be doing something wrong, right? Like, I must be, missing something. Like, there's something here that I'm missing. Well, I think what I might be missing is, okay, like, I fell down on the spikes last time, and it didn't hurt me. Like, the spikes just didn't hurt me. Not sure what that was all about. So I'm gonna see if I can replicate it, like, if I can get the spikes to not hurt me. So I'm just gonna go straight down now. Okay, look, I went straight down, and it still hurt me, so... So this is what happens. Yeah, see, if you use, 4 credits, you lose your soul. You know, the... Yeah, you lose your soul, so... So you can't, you can't get the true ending of the game now that you've lost your soul. That's unfortunate, right? But I just want to see if I can get past this stage. Like, I need to come up with a good strategy to get past the stage, because I was doing pretty good up until now, right? Like, I pretty much had the game down till I got to this point, and when I got to this point, it all just fell apart. Like, it all just went to hell. But, you know, since I don't have to worry about my soul anymore, since I've already lost that, yeah, let's just try to get through this. There has to be, like, some kind of secret, right? Like, there must be, like, a, I don't know, maybe a secret I'm missing or something. If there is, I don't know about it. Okay, so, like, look, you can't just jump. Yeah, see, my thought was that, okay, let me see how much I can control my jump. Like, okay, like, see, look, you can't really control your jump all that well. Let's try that again. You know, same tactic. Let's just see if we can control our jump enough to not fall into the pit of death. So let's see if we can do this without falling to death this time. See, like, what I want to do is I want to control my jump very, very carefully. Like really fucking carefully. Yeah, so let's see if this works or if I'm totally off base yet again. Alright, so, like, when I get here, I just want to go straight down the middle. No, I can't even do that. You can't even do that. Yeah, see, like, when you try that, yeah, when you try to do that, it just knocks you down. Like, there's bubbles coming from both sides, and, you know, you get hit by them, you're done. So, okay. Let's not even waste time with the power-up, because we're not gonna, at our rate, we're not gonna even make it, so... Just don't even worry about any power-ups. You're not gonna live long enough to make use of them. So, okay. So I want to try this again, like that. Wait a minute. I think I might know what I need to do. Okay. Okay. I think I might need to jump into it and, oh, look at that, all those, you know, anyone watching, oh no, they're just like, not having any of this. I expected that. But yeah, like, I'm just trying to figure out how to beat this. I don't know, like, tell me if there's something I'm not seeing here, okay? Like, if there's something I'm not seeing to get past, you know, the rows of spikes that are keeping me down. Because, like, I don't know, I'm trying here, and I can't... Yeah, you can't damage the spikes, so you can't do that. And you can't just, like, you can't just make the jump, because, yeah, that doesn't work out so well. So, like, if I do that... Okay, if I do that, I can kind of make it for, like, a second, but not really. Yeah, that doesn't work out so well. And, man, it looks like everyone's gone now. Oh, man. Kind of figured it. What time is it? Oh man, later than I intended to stay. I had said I could stay up to 3, but no, I'm not. That's not happening. So okay, like, I'm just trying to work out a good strategy, you know, so that next time I stream this game, I can just breeze through it. All right, so I'm trying to come up with a good, sound, legit strategy that I can use to. clear right through this stage. Just get right on through it. Okay, so I kind of had something there. I think I might be onto something. Can I jump up here? Okay, so like I can land on those little platforms, right? Yeah, I can land on those little platforms, and yeah, I can kind of get something out of that. So, okay, I have a plan now. All right, I got a plan. I got a game plan. I'm gonna land on that little ledge, and yeah, I'm gonna make the jump from there. Yeah, I'm gonna land on the ledge, and I'm gonna make the jump from the ledge, and that way, like, that way I can just kind of get down to the next area, and, you know, I won't need to worry too much about it. Like, I won't have to worry about being assaulted from, like, two angles at once while I try to get into a fucking pit. So here's what I'm gonna do. Alright. So, okay, if I can jump down from here. Okay, you cannot do that. You cannot do that. That does not work. So hey, there was my strategy, right? Yeah, strategy not so effective. Unfortunately. So yeah, I'm just at a loss. I don't really know of a good way to do this. I really don't know of a good way to do this at all. I'll have to look it up. Like, I'll have to look up, I'll have to watch someone play this again, and just specifically for this level. Like, just specifically I have to watch someone beat this level of the game. Because I don't know how the hell I'm supposed to do it. I really don't. Unless, like, okay. That last bubble, like, see that last bubble, it just kind of comes out of nowhere, right? So, okay, like, what if I just kind of... Yeah, what if I just kind of do that, right? Are the bubbles gonna respawn? That's what I'm curious about. Are the bubbles gonna fucking respawn? No, they don't. They don't fucking respawn, so... I see no way to do that. Like, I see absolutely no way to fucking do that. Like, you're trapped between two chains, and, you can't, like, there's not enough maneuverability in this game to get it, right? The bubbles will hit you. Like, no matter what you do, the bubbles are gonna hit you. I don't see a good way around this. Like, I tried the whole, you know, the kind of exploit thing right here, right? And it doesn't really work. It really doesn't work. Yeah, the exploit tactic doesn't work. So I'm gonna again take things slowly. Alright, taking things slow. So what I know is like I can land on the edges of the platforms. Yeah, see that's a little bit buggy. I don't know. I'm gonna have to look this up. I won't bore you all with this. It's going nowhere for me personally though. I'll look it up. I'll see what I have to do in order to beat this game. Well, in order to get past this one stage. I just don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. But yeah, that's all for right now. Yeah, I think that's all for now. It's 12:30. It's a good time to get some fucking sleep. That's what it is. Let me go back to my, Let's go back to the desktop. So, okay, that was Maldita Castilla. It's free, you can, you know, grab it if you want it. Okay, so, yeah, let's see. Anyone still putting up with this horse shit? A couple people, I'm surprised. So yeah, tomorrow. That's about all for today. Tomorrow, what I'm gonna try to do is, I might have another one of these long streams. I might not. I might do a afternoon then midnight. Yeah, what I want to continue, I want to beat Dino Crisis. Yeah, I've been at Dino Crisis for way too long, so I'm gonna try to beat Dino Crisis. Finally finish the game. Don't know if it'll be possible, but hey, I'm gonna try. Okay. So yeah, I want to beat Dino Crisis, and I'll do another episode or two of Siren Blood Curse, and then I think I'm not gonna do Legacy of Kain. I think I think for the midnight for the evening slash midnight stream, I'm probably going to do yeah, I'm probably gonna do King's Quest Mask of Eternity. I'd already started that, but I wanna make some progress in that because it's been a while. And it's not a, anyone not familiar with it, it's not your average King's Quest game. It's kind of a very dark action RPG. Yeah, it's fun though. It's got some hilarious voice acting. But yeah, so that's kind of the game plan for tomorrow. That's what I got on the plate. Yeah, so hope you all enjoyed tonight. Tune again next time if you want more of this. And as always, I'm always up for suggestions on games to play too. Always looking for something else to torture people with, but I want to finish what's on my plate now. I got too many games going. Gotta finish some of them. So that's all for tonight. Yeah, go to fucking sleep. Go to bed. Just get the fuck out of here. All right. Later.